Kevin is in our meetings every day, comes in, we talk through everything that was installed every day. I know the line of communication is wide open between those two guys. You know, I know they've met weekly on Tuesdays to make sure everything was good. And I don't feel that at all. I don't. You know, Kevin's always been open and very communicative with all the players and coaches as well.
That was Cleveland's Alex Van Pelt addressing a Cleveland.com report from Mary Kay Cabot that Baker Mayfield isn't happy with Kevin Stefanski's play calling, that he's not being put in position to succeed, and that if Mayfield doesn't get reassurance that things will change next season, he'll consider asking to be traded. Now, of course, Baker is undergoing surgery to repair a torn labrum in his non-throwing shoulder and will not play in Week 18. But, Michael, we talked off the top of the show about movies we've seen before with Antonio Brown. We have seen movies before in relationships, I should say, in like this quite frequently in Cleveland when it comes to their quarterbacks. And, of course, Baker Mayfield responded on Twitter, specifically to Mary Kay Cabot, saying, "Clickbait, you and many other Cleveland local media continue to be drama-stirring reporters with no sources or facts. Don't put words in my mouth so you can put food on your table. I'm not your puppet." Here's the thing. Okay. Here's the thing.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, I'm off tip of your tongue?
No. I want you to go first. I want you to go first.
Sure?
All right. Go first. Yes.
Okay. I'll try not to take as long as usual. Because I'm thinking about relationships.
Take your time, preacher.
Thinking about relationships in this context. The Browns are that franchise, and I've said this before, the Browns are that franchise that shouldn't be in a relationship with a quarterback, okay? Because one of the reasons that it's not working out with Baker Mayfield, and there are a lot, he's been bad this year. I think Pro Football Focus had him 30th ranked quarterback this year. He's been beat up, okay? And the circumstances around him have contributed to it, of course. Maybe it's play calling. I'm sure there's some of that. It's personnel, injuries, blah, blah, blah. I ain't here to make excuses. I'm just laying out the facts, okay?
Right.
Do with those what you will. But part of the reason is their number one overall pick from 2018, who led them to the playoffs last year, looked really good last year. They beat Pittsburgh in the playoffs last year. Looked like they had finally settled that revolving door at that position. Here we go again with the same old baggage and toxicity from previous relationships getting in the way of this one being a fruitful one. Whether it's internal organizational dysfunction or whether it's the media, the fan base, whatever it is. What I see here is the Browns browning when it comes to a quarterback again. Now, you may say, well, Michael, Baker Mayfield ain't that good. I agree. I think Baker Mayfield is pumpkin pie. Not sweet potato pie, pumpkin pie. Okay? As in he'll do. But you can do a lot better. So when I see a headline that says Baker Mayfield may ask for a trade, if I'm the Browns, even after all the quarterbacks we've been through since we came back in 1999, I'm not letting that contribute to my future decision making. I'm not going to settle just because I don't, you know, I'm afraid of Baker Mayfield going somewhere else. What do we like to say on this show, Michael? Go be great somewhere else. That means you could
be great somewhere
else. You're just not going to be great here. It's just not set up for you to be great here. So if I'm the Browns, I'm saying bet. You want to get traded? How about this? That's a win-win for both of us. Because here's why. Michael, I think about Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. If you don't know him by now, four years in, going into a contract year, then you will never, ever, ever know him and whether or not he's your franchise quarterback. This ain't a Johnny Taylor situation where it's cheaper to keep her, okay? A Teddy Pendergrass, Harold Melvin, and the Blue Notes where it's like, hey, we don't know what he is, but we know we ain't about to break him off and give him the bag long term, so you might as well move on from him right now. And the difference between now and previous years is it looks like there's enough talent to make Cleveland somewhere where other quarterbacks may want to play, and who knows, maybe they thrive at long last.
Oh man, you took me down the road now, because I was gonna, I'm gonna get to what I want to say, but you have to hit me with Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. I like that song, but I like when they, what's it? I lost
Miss You.
It.
Oh, was baby, it, I lost it.
Yeah, that's a great one.
I lost it, yeah.
And then.
I thought you were talking about Teddy. I miss you. Yeah.
You talking about Teddy. Close the door. Close the door. All right, so close it. Look, let's start here. You said when the Browns came back, remember you just said that, when they came back to Cleveland.
99.
That means they left Cleveland. They left, they had to leave to come back. The year they left Cleveland was the year that Baker Mayfield was born. I just want to settle this right here. I'm going to settle it. Because I know we have talked critically the last 48 hours about a media member, Hub Arkish, in Chicago. And we pretty much clowned him, rightfully so. We'll get to him later today, maybe. But I'm going to go the other way with Mary Kay Cabot. In 1995, when the Browns left Cleveland for Baltimore, Mary Kay Cabot was covering the team. 1995 is also the year that Baker Mayfield was born. So, Baker, I just want you to get this straight. You were in diapers. You were literally in diapers when Mary Kay Cabot was covering the team. So no, you can't come for her. You can't come for her. You can't come for the queen. You missed. Now, she is not in business that long at the same publication by making up stuff, by inventing sources. You may not know who her sources are, but I'm going to bet that her sources are more accurate than your passes.
Ooh. Right?
So look.
Damn. Oh.
Now,
that was ether. That was ether.
Yeah.
that itch that make your soul burn slow. Ooh, man.
There it is.
Ooh, that's a pull quote, Brandon. Brandon, that's a pull quote. Mary Kay Cabot's source is more accurate than your passes.
Right. This is not a Mary. He's trying to torch Mary Kay Cabot. This is not a Mary Kay Cabot story. This is, unfortunately, a Baker Mayfield story, and this is where it's sad. It's also a Cleveland story. This is sad.
Yeah.
It may have been Mary Kay who wrote earlier, or somebody else, but it's accurate. 17 out of 18. They missed the playoffs 17 out of the last 18 years. And this year is the most Cleveland year ever, where, and people in Cleveland know it, I'm not gonna go over the history, but there have been so many examples where the preseason hype is, they're gonna win the World Series, they're gonna go to the Super Bowl for the first time.
Didn't I tell you I wasn't talking about this team? Didn't I tell you early?
Did.
I'm not talking about the Browns no more. I'm not falling for this banana in the tailpipe.
It looks so good. Even their loss, the way they were eliminated from the playoffs, gave you a
all
hope,
paper.
Possibility. They lose to Kansas City. They had a chance at Kansas City. They had some things go against them. They had a backup quarterback, Chad Henne, pick up a key fourth down against them in Kansas City when Patrick Mahomes got. They had so many things looking good. Yeah. And here it is. Here they are again. Right. They finally had the right coach. Now the coach is feuding with the quarterback. We've seen this story before. No, he is. You know, this is what it is.
Okay. You say that rather convincingly. You say that definitively, because, like he is. Like, one good year.
Okay.
I mean.
This is what it's like. This is what it's like. Some athletes, and I don't know if Baker Mayfield is this guy, but some athletes want it both ways. Aaron Rodgers is like this sometimes. Russell Wilson was like this in the offseason. They want to get the message out, but then when the message comes back to them, they want to blame the media.
Yeah, they got to clean it up.
You want the message out, but you don't want to deal with the consequences of having the message out. You want somebody else to be the bad guy.
But even when Baker has said publicly supports the notion that he's not happy, he's questioned Stefanski's play calling publicly.
Okay. I don't know who he is. I don't know what kind of quarterback he's going to be. You know, you probably got it right. He's pumpkin pie. He's just a good serviceable starting quarterback in the NFL. I'm not into ranking him, but let's say number the 18th best quarterback in football. You think that's too high? Ooh.
Off the top of my head, it feels that way. It feels that way.
Okay.
Feels that way.
Then it's not, maybe it's not even that deep then. If he's not as high as 18, I think Cleveland They you're right. They're both going to get what they want. He wants to start
18 is the magic
else.
Number. He makes 18 next year. Like, if you're the Browns, if you're Andrew Berry, you ain't signing him to a long-term extension. So that toxicity, right. that negativity, I mean, this is uncalled for, but it wasn't that long ago his wife and he were addressing death threats that fans were sending him. I mean, whether it's the negativity, the baggage, the toxicity, you think it's going to get better for him going into next year when there's pressure to get back to the playoffs and pressure in a contract year? Like, just cut bait now. Like, Michael, I don't know if this happened to you with various I'm going back to relationships, okay? You've been in a relationship with a woman, and y'all been together for a few years. And it feels like every night when y'all go to bed, y'all got to have the existential conversation about what is this relationship?
What are we doing?
It's like, where are we going? What are we doing? Like, what am I, okay? And it's like, at a certain point, if you don't know, you got to poop or get off the pot, you know?
Right.
And so with this, with Baker Mayfield, they're not putting a ring on this. They're not committing to him long term. He knows it. They knew it.
Well,
Marcellus knew it. And Baker Mayfield should have known better.
Should have known better.
I mean, like, you know what I'm saying? Like every if the writing is but on maybe. The wall. This is not a long-term thing, and next year is not going to get any better. If you don't know, next year, the last year of a rookie contract is not the year to find out. He looked like he was the franchise guy last year. Not so much this year. I don't think you find out next year, especially if you are Baker Mayfield, you want to quit before they fire you.
Yeah, I just feel for him. I feel for him because they're back in familiar territory, and I thought they had graduated from this. I thought, you know, with Kevin Stefanski and winning the playoff game last year against
the
Steelers.
Looked like the merry-go-round had stopped, yeah.
That they figured out what their offense was going to be with Chubb and Kareem Hunt and just a running-based offense with Baker Mayfield making these decisions. And now you think about it. So there's a reported rift between – I'll say it that way. I'll be nice. Even though I believe it. A reported rift between Stefanski and Mayfield. You already got Odell Beckham who left town. Mm-hmm. And you're supposed to be a contender in the final game of the season. You're going against a team that you blew out. Like, you're the one that Cincinnati has blown out everybody else in the AFC North except for you. You blew them out the first time. They blew out the Ravens. They blew out the Steelers a couple times. But you had them. And instead of this game meaning something, the Battle of Ohio is now the battle of backup quarterbacks because Joe Burrow is not going to play. Baker Mayfield's not going to play. Cincinnati's going somewhere. And Cleveland, again, is home for the postseason. It's just a sad story. So they almost, not just starting over from a quarterback standpoint, but I think they got to reassess, okay, what is this? If we don't have Baker Mayfield, if he doesn't want to be here, he's not buying in. What are we doing at quarterback? What are we doing with our philosophy? Because we had, theoretically, a number one wide receiver who said, I'm out, and he's proven himself somewhere else. Can Baker Mayfield do the same thing? Is Baker Mayfield going to go somewhere else?
They got to look in the mirror. Is it us? That's what I'm saying.
Maybe it's
certain organizations shouldn't be in a relationship. I don't know. But to your point about the AFC North, we can go to break. Roll that music, Gary. We can go to break. In AFC North, Cincinnati's doing this. They're set at quarterback. Okay. Baltimore's set at quarterback. And they may not be doing this right now, but they'll be back. Pittsburgh, they'll find a quarterback. And you know they'll find everything else because that's what Pittsburgh does.
Maybe
so
Baker.
Cleveland could be staring. That would be fun. That'd be fun and interesting. But having said that, Cleveland, if they're not careful and they don't figure out, you know, beyond injuries and bad luck, why they can't seem to get out of their own way, they could be back in the AFC North basement, back in the doghouse and not in a good way.
Hey, thanks for watching Brother from Another on YouTube. Make sure you hit subscribe before you leave and be sure to watch us 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Peacock. Appreciate you.